We'll see a sequencer function in scientific SMPS. So first, in this sequencer software, we'll select the COM port in which the power supply is connected. Baud rate will be according to the baud rate set in the power supply. By default, it is 9600, and we'll press connect. Once we press connect, you can see the power supply is entered remote mode. Now it means the power supply is connected with the software. Now here we'll create the sequences. This is first column is of serial number, second is of voltage, third is of current, and fourth is of time. So first we'll make serial number 1, voltage, let's say 5 volt, current 1 ampere, time 5 seconds. Now again, second step, voltage 10, current 2, time 10 seconds. Step 3, voltage 15, current 3 amps, time 5 seconds. Step 4, voltage 20, current 4, time 5 seconds. Now step 5, voltage 25, current 5, time again 10 seconds. Now at last, 6th step, voltage 0, current 0, and time is of 5 seconds. Now we'll just press this start sequence button and the sequence will start working. And we can see the live graph here. The readings, first step is 5 volt, 1 ampere, so 5 volt, 5 volt and 1 ampere. Red line is of voltage, blue line is of current. Second step is 10 volt, 2 ampere, so 10 volt, 2 ampere. This is the actual output of the power supply. Third step is 15 volt, 3 ampere for 5 seconds, so 15 volt, 3 ampere for 5 seconds. Now again it went to 20 volt, 4 ampere as per the sequence. So 20 volt, 4 ampere. Now last step is 25.5, so 25.5. Now it will go to 0.0 and it will stop the sequence. So this is a live graph of the which is the output of the power supply. Red is of voltage, blue is of current. Once the sequence is completed, a pop-up window will come as sequence completed. We'll just have to press OK here. Now here we have some extra facilities also, like if we want to run the sequence for more than one time, so we have to give that number here. Let's say I want to run this sequence for 2 times, so I will just include 2 here and same process, start the sequence. So the sequence will run for 2 times. We can have, so 5 volt 1 ampere, 10 volt 1 ampere. Now it will go to third step, 15 volt, 3 ampere. You can see the power supply also, the data is getting refreshed. Now it is 20 volt, 5 ampere, 25 volt, 5 ampere. Here also you can see the actual output of the power supply. So as we have given,
it's an analog power supply, software is not.
So here you can see the sequences ran for 2 times. This is the first time, this is the second time. So now you can have your sequence saved in CSV and you can load that sequence also. To do that, first we'll create a CSV here. So this is serial number as it was in table. This is the voltage, this is the current, this is the time. So if I want to recall this file in that software, so just what we have to do is, we'll browse the file from here. First test 5. Open. Now load sequence. Once I load this sequence, you can see the table has updated according to the sequence we have provided in the Excel sheet. This is the voltage, this is the current, this is time, and you can see the preview of your sequence also. This is the preview of your sequence which is going to run. So if I start the program now, you can see You can stop the running sequence from this button, stop sequence. You can clear the graph from here. And add and delete line is for here. If you want to delete a line, let's say I want to delete this line, just press delete line, it will automatically get deleted. Now if you want to add line here, select the line and add, so it will add a line at the bottom.